to go forward, and I believe that despite some faltering along the way, we have come a long way in 3 years. I want to thank particularly the team that has been working behind the scenes.
Yes.
These people would not want to take any accolades for this, but people like Sister Vilma, yeah. Harvey Jarrett, Sister Madge, Rodney, and the whole of the team. It's not about individuals, it's all about God. And I know that some people have worked tirelessly behind the scenes, and in the role of chairman, I just want to preface what I'm going to say by saying we appreciate you very much. And we thank God for you. I echo the words of Overseer Queensborough when he talked about the legacy that we have received and that which we have in our hands which we must take forward. Names like the late Benjamin Pitt were mentioned this morning. Bishop Ellie White, Rufus Jordan is my own bishop, late of Wilson. Still alive with us, Bishop H.T. Rowe, Bishop Sidney Dunn, Brown, Simmons, Miller, and all of these, they have laid on us, I believe, a great challenge.
Yes.
And I was reminded as I looked at the Olympics that we are actually in a baton change. And what I noted in the Olympics was that although there were teams that had great skill and potential,
yes.
But because the baton change was not done correctly, some runners ran out of the box before they got to the baton. Talk to me, somebody. That meant disqualification.
Yes, sir.
So the best runners did not necessarily win the gold because the change did not take place right. Well, praise God. So I'm thankful that you're talking about vision here tonight. And as I listened to Overseer Queensborough, I was reminded 1995 when I approached the NatWest bank manager in Manchester to ask for a loan. And when I showed him a sample of the membership of the church, he asked me, is that the Linton's splinter group? Because on the sheet there were about 10 people called Linton. And then he said to me, I know exactly who the Catholics are. I know who the Church of England are. I know who the Methodists are, but I don't know who the Apostolics are. And I vowed to him in that office in 1995.
Right.
So long as Keith Linton has got breath in his body and blood running in my veins, you will hear about the Apostolic Church. It's great to know somebody.
Yes, sir.
Our Father has been on prayer.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Peter. Thank you, Lord. We have got a great debt and a great job that's on our hands. And I want to say that recently I've been reading Luke's Gospel 16 and verse 8, and in particular the last clause which says, for the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light. For the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light. That is an indictment for us. Because what he says is that this ought not to be so,
no.
But the people of the world can mobilize.
Yes, sir.
They can work together.
Yes.
They plan together.
Uh-huh.
And because they can effectually get the job done, yes. Then it makes us look as though we talk a lot.
Yes.
We have great swelling words, but when it comes down to it, we appear to be more foolish than the children of this world.
Yes.
We have heard about Barack Obama's presidential campaign. Why did it happen?
All right.
It happened because a man with a vision had a team of people behind him who provided all the resources and did not pull him down,
all right.
But supported him.
Right.
And the rest is history.
Yes, sir.
Let's praise the Lord so much.